What's up, folks? I'm back with another reaction, back with some more Beastie Boys. Going back to Paul's Boutique, up to the third track now. I am interested, a couple of you had given me some really interesting information the last couple of days. Apparently, like, you know, they had moved from a different label after their first album, Licensed to Ill, and they did this album, which I guess was... ultimately, you know, they were sort of using samples and, you know, they're trying to like do like a proper hip-hop album, but apparently it was sort of a flop. Someone was saying that it didn't really get good sales and the guys were kind of drifting apart at this point, and it was like maybe they weren't even going to do another album at all. But then apparently, I think Ad Rock like encountered some Dust Brothers music and was like, wait a minute, I want to do some flow over this. And that kind of led to them sort of reconvening and sort of like figuring it out and ultimately doing the album Check Your Head, which was mostly with instruments. So yeah, I'm beginning to, you know, through your information, through your comments, once again, shout out to all of you, but I'm beginning to kind of, you know, stitch together a little bit of an understanding about what was going on while these albums were being made. So yeah, we're up to the third tune in Paul's Boutique, which is... Johnny Ryall, like Ryall. I'm not sure how you say that. We'll say Ryall, maybe. But yeah, it's a name. It's, you know, hard to make much of a name without further context. So yeah, perhaps the song or the track itself will be about Johnny Ryall or Ryall. I'm gonna say Ryall. But yeah, it's, you know, it's sometimes with song titles I can sort of speculate a little bit about potential themes, but when it's a name, especially a name that's not, you know, a name of a famous person that is well known, it's hard to make much of it, so we'll just get right to it. This is Beastie Boys from their 1989 album Paul's Boutique, Johnny Ryall. Oh, right, and someone else mentioned Hurricane's not on this album, so is it Ad Rock? Is he the one on the decks? So is Johnny Ryall one of these people sleeping out on the street in a box? He's covered with flies. He's got the hand-me-down Pumas and the tie-dye. Hand-me-down Pumas. Get your head together. The bird is the word and your light is a feather. Bird is the word. I just reacted to a techno remix of Rivington's Bird. The bird is the word. Rockabilly from the days of old. Had like a Saxon or at least brass of some kind. There are a lot of other groups that do this, where they like, they're all flowing in the same verse, like they're all like, one line, like two lines, one line. I mean, it's like, you know, I listen to a lot of hip-hop groups with multiple MCs, like Hieroglyphic, Wu-Tang, but like, the Visionaries, J5, they all like take turns, they all like, I do a verse, you do a verse, you do a verse. I don't think that there's any other hip-hop groups I know that, like, they all just kind of like jump in and they're like rhyming with the other person's line. Like, I don't know. I'm curious about their sort of their writing method. Like, you know, how much of it is sort of in the moment improvised to a certain degree, or how much do they really just like get down, they get it all on paper, and then it's just about figuring out how they're going to do it. It makes me wonder, like, if they really write verses that way, where it's like, you know, someone writes one line and then another person's like, okay, I'm going to take that and I'm going to write my line to it. Or if like someone writes an entire verse, but then they sort of spread around those lines and sort of alternate in the way they deliver them. I am curious now, but that was cool. I really enjoyed it. And for some reason, I was able to pick up like more of the bars in that one. Some of the hip hop tunes in Check Your Head, like, I don't know if it's because of the loud and kind of funky bass and whatever, but a couple of those tracks, it was like, oh, you know, I got to go back and listen again. I didn't catch too many. You know, not that I caught everything here, but I did catch some more lines than in some of the other ones. But yeah, it was cool. And I'm interested. Johnny Ryall, like, I think there's a lot of interesting things going on there, but I still don't know his full story. So I'm going to have to come back and listen to the tune some more. But yeah, let me know what you think of that one. A couple of you mentioned there's a couple more, like, two for ones that I should do on this album. So just remind me if there's anything coming up in the next couple tracks, but yeah, we'll be going through this one pretty quickly because I do want to get to Ill Communication eventually, and then when I get there and finish that one, you know, we'll see what the best album is to get after that. And, you know, please do shout out a suggestion if you think, you know, there's a really good one to get, you know, whether it's, you know, jumping back, because I don't, you know, fair to say, I don't have License to Ill, so if that one is, you know, worth going back for. And then I someone else mentioned that, like, Pollywog Stew is sort of like a compilation that they did, and then like there is some other punk stuff too. I remember Anthony, like, someone else commented on Pollywog Stew, and then I think he corrected and was like, yeah, that's kind of right, but it's actually a little more complicated. So basically I'm just wondering, I'm thinking way ahead because I still have two full albums to go through here, but yeah, I'm just wondering, like, once I get to the end of Ill Communication, like, what the best next album to get will be. So shout it out if you have a clear idea on that. Let me know what you think of this one. And other than that, thank you for listening and watching. I will see you next time.